Turkish President Recep Erdogan has finally arrived in Doha for the Qatar-Turkey strategic dialogue. And will we be seeing maroon and white sparks in Emirati skies this national day? Stay tuned. Despite ongoing tensions, Bahrain's crown prince may be in Doha soon. Finally, let's take a look at a quick recap of this Monday's FIFA Arab Cup matches.
Hey, I'm Farah, and these are the top stories for today's roundup.
We start off in Doha, where Turkish President Recep Erdogan has arrived for the Qatar-Turkey strategic dialogue. The two nations are expected to sign up to a dozen agreements during the two-day dialogue, through which the president said ties between his country and Qatar, as well as Gulf nations, will be enhanced. Over the next 2 days, top Turkish and Qatari officials will meet to promote relations in various fields. Over in the UAE, a leaked document has revealed that Emirati authorities will be planning a number of celebrations in light of Qatar's National Day on December 18th. As part of the celebrations, the UAE is expected to illuminate its iconic buildings, including the Burj Khalifa, with the colors of the Qatari flag for the first time in years. This comes as the two Gulf nations work together to strengthen ties after the UAE, along with Saudi Arabia, Bahrain, and Egypt, imposed a years-long blockade on Qatar. And on that note, prominent Qatari journalist Jabal Al-Harmi has shared that Bahrain's crown prince, Salman bin Hamad Al-Khalifa, will soon be making his way to Doha. Experts have questioned whether this was a move on the kingdom's part to speed up the restoration of ties with Qatar. Despite the end of the GCC crisis, Bahrain has been ruthless in its anti-Qatar sentiment, especially on its media platforms. However, the visit may indicate that Manama is now ready to make amends with Doha after it cut ties in 2017. And finally, here's how Monday's Arab Cup matches played out. Qatar bagged a dazzling win against Iraq with 3 goals, snagging 9 points in its groups and qualifying for the quarterfinals. This means that this is the end of Iraq's run at the 2021 Arab Cup. Tunisia has also qualified for the quarterfinals after a 1-0 win against the UAE. Syria never saw it coming after a comeback from Mauritania, which resulted in a 2-1 win for the latter, though both nations failed to make it to the quarters. And finally, Oman has also secured its spot after beating Bahrain 3-0 at the Ahmed bin Ali Stadium.
That was all for today, but if you want to read more of our stories, head on to DohaNews.co.